Your life story is a great way to invite someone to a deeper relationship with you, and also a bridge to the gospel message. Now, don't worry if you've been struggling with it or you don't feel it's complete, especially you perfectionists. Take the time, try the practice, the peer-to-peer exercises, and you'll find it become more and more natural. Well, today we're going to move to step 5 in our process, the gospel message itself. The good news that we can have a relationship with God through His Son, Jesus Christ. We're going to be going through a booklet called the Would You Like to Know God Personally Tract. But before we do that, let me ask you this. I bet you've had a modeling of evangelism that looks something like a guy running up to another guy and thumping over the head with a big black Bible. That really turns us off. And by now, I hope you see that it's really all about relationships. And frankly, it can be a lot of fun as well. Before we get into our little tool, I want to review a few principles, or laws really. They'll act as a refresher for some of the things we've learned already and set us up for success as we share the gospel message. When it comes to sharing our faith, the first law is the law of abundance. This law simply states that the greatest thing that you and I have to offer to a lost world is a consistent display of the Spirit-filled life. In John 10:10, Jesus said, "I have come that they may have life and have it to the full." A friend of mine says that everyone is looking for a trade-up, and that includes the spiritual part of their life as well. So here's the question. Is your life a trade-up or a trade-down to those you interact with? The second law is the law of the supernatural. This law basically states that God's in charge. The definition of successful witnessing is taking the initiative in the power of the Holy Spirit to share our faith and leaving the results up to God. I love this law. It takes a lot of weight off my shoulders and allows me to sleep at night knowing that God is the one who's working behind the scenes to draw people to Himself. Now, it doesn't take me off the hook. I have the privilege to pray for them. Now, I got to confess something. Prayer is not my strong point. I'd rather just really get in there and do stuff. But when I am praying, I tend to see God really working, and their reception to Christ just increases. And guess what? I change too, like I should be surprised. So let's take some time and pray for the people on our friends list. The law of proximity is another way of saying, burst your bubble. One of the other things that we face besides our fear and is a hurdle for us getting out of our bubble is simply time. Every one of us is busy. Between family and work or school, there's not a lot of margin left. So here's what I do. I take a look at my life and I say, what am I currently doing that I could do with non-Christians? Maybe I'm doing it with too many Christians right now. For instance, I love tennis, so in the summertime, I join a tennis club. It's fantastic, I meet so many people. In the winter, it's hockey. So I join a league where, well, the majority of guys aren't Christians. Both of them I'm already doing, but I just decide to do them with those who don't know the Lord. So take a look at your inventory list and ask yourself this. Could you do a little shuffling? Could you find some way of taking some time to spend it with those who don't yet know the Lord? The fourth law is the law of preparedness. Most of us spend way more time preparing for our careers than we ever do learning how to share our faith. So think of all this time that we've spent together as just being very valuable. Now, the fifth law is the law of process, and I love this law. This law basically states that all people are on a spiritual journey, you, me, and all our friends and family. The key here is to learn how to discern where these people may be in their journey. This is one of my favorite laws because I love the fact that it gives me so much hope as I interact with my friends. The angle scale shows how this works. So for example, the center point suggests the time where the individual begins a relationship with Christ. Anything before this point represents a pre-Christian, and afterward would represent our own growth point in our walks with God. Knowing this process helps me better understand Paul's statement in 2 Corinthians 2:14, where he says, "But thanks be to God, who always leads us in triumphal procession in Christ, and through us spreads everywhere the fragrance of the knowledge of Him." We are the fragrance of Christ. Every time I have a conversation with someone, anyone, I'm trusting that God is using me to help them progress in their spiritual journey. If someone is around, say, -4, they may be willing to attend church or an event, but those who are further away would not likely be interested in getting too close. Think about your friends you wrote down earlier, the ones on your list. Where would you say they are on this scale? Take a moment to quickly jot down a number or range of numbers next to their names. Several years ago, my pastor told me a great story. He was going for a walk on the seawall in Vancouver, and he saw this guy down the water and he was fishing. He had this net out and he was pulling in all these different fish and throwing them in a bucket. A little further on, there was a boy sitting on a dock. And as he fished, he had his rod and he'd catch them one at a time. He'd pull them in. And even further, he came along a blue heron. And the blue heron was just quietly going through the shallow water and boom, he'd get a fish. They were all doing the same thing. They were all fishing. But they all had a different approach. The law of approach states that each one of us is going to share our faith in a different way. We're all unique. In Psalm 139:14, it says, "I praise you because I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Your works are wonderful. I know that full well." Each one of us is called to be a witness for Christ, but we're going to do it differently. So think about this. Are you an Apostle Paul, an intellectual style? Or how about Dorcas in the Bible? She was a woman who served people. Perhaps you're like that. Or how about Peter, the guy who just sort of stuck his foot in his mouth, but it was bold. Each one of us is different. And though we may be different, we're still called to be witnesses. The final law is the law of respect. This simply states that we need to have the right attitude when we're sharing Christ with people. We need to be sensitive to them. As we're walking in the power of the Holy Spirit and listening to Him, we'll get very good at this. So as you think of these seven evangelistic laws, think of how you are doing in them. The more you watch them, obey them, the more successful you're going to be in sharing your faith. One of the greatest challenges we have to sharing our faith is simply knowing what to say when someone actually wants to pray to receive Christ. You know, the classic is, "Well, I'm going to take you to church," or "Who else can talk to you?" Sharing the gospel message is very simple. In our next session, we're going to jump into a little tool called the Would You Like to Know God Personally booklet. Now, this tool has been used in hundreds of languages all over the world to lead millions of people to Christ. Now, it's not the only way to share your faith, but it is an effective one. So grab a booklet on the way out tonight, and when we get together next week, we're going to dig into it. But right now, I really got to jump into this grill.